Hello friends, a very hearty welcome to my students of Open Mind channel. So in the previous classes we were discussing about the electricity of 10th class chapter, and we went through many topics like what's a charge, what's a current, what is the resistivity, what is the resistance of a current, Ohm's law, on what factors does the resistance of any conductor depends, what is ohmic material, what is non-ohmic material. So now we will study another topic today, which is known as resistors in series. Now you know that the resistances are there which does not allow the flow of current, that means it blocks the flow of current a little bit. So the resistors, those things, those substances which obstructs or which blocks the flow of current are called as resistors. So we can arrange the resistors in two ways in a circuit. The first is the series combination and the second one is parallel combination. So the first one is series combination. And the second one is parallel combination. So now we will be seeing first the series combination, that is the resistors in series. For that we will take three resistors in series, that means in a single line, R1, R2 and R3, and we will connect the voltmeter this way with parallel. Parallel connection. Okay, and now this circuit is being completed, so we connect it to a cell or a battery and to a key. First to a key, then we have to connect it to the ammeter, that is the positive and negative, and then we connect it to the battery. Okay, so now this type of circuit is made for a series connection. Here we take R1, R2 and R3, all the three resistors in a series combination. Now suppose the current I is flowing in this direction. So whenever the current I is flowing in this direction, you might have seen in the ammeter, if you see in the ammeter by making this circuit, there will be no change in the amount of flow of current which is passing through R1, R2 and R3. That means that the current flowing through each resistors remains the same, but the potential difference across each resistors is different, and the total potential difference is equal to the potential difference across each individual resistors. That means if you take the total potential difference as V, so along this will be just equal to the potential difference across this R1, the potential difference across this R2 and the potential difference across this R3. So this is all voltmeters. So suppose this is V1, this is V2 and this is V3. So capital V is equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now you know what is Ohm's law. According to Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. Now for all this V1, V2 and V3, I said you the current flowing through each resistors remains the same. That means V1 will be equals to I into R1, V1, it's not I, it's 1. V2 will be equals to IR2 and V3 will be equals to IR3. Now we substitute this, that means the total potential difference across the two ends of the circuit will be equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now substitute the values. IR is equals to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So this implies I is common over here. Please take it out, R1 plus R2 plus R3. This I and this I gets cancelled. So R is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. That means in a series combination, the total resistance across the two ends of the circuit will be equal to sum of all the resistances. So this type of connections is called as series connections because all are in the same line. Now we will see how we make the parallel combination. So now let's see How we find out the total resistance along the circuit in case of parallel combination. Now, as you might have seen, in case of parallel conditions, the three resistances R1, R2 and R3 are connected in parallel. After that, they are connected to the voltmeter to measure the potential difference across the two ends of the resistance or the total resistance, and this is the battery and this is the ammeter. Here this is the key. Now, as I said to you, in the previous series combination, that the amount of current remains the same. Here the amount of potential difference, that means the amount of potential difference across the two ends of R1, R2 and R3, it remains the same, but the amount of current changes, because whenever the current will come from here, it will be divided into three parts, this way, this way and this way. So the amount of current flowing through the three resistors will be totally different. So as a result, we will now see what is the changes we get in the derivation. So the potential difference across the two ends of the circuit remains the same. So we know from Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. Here V is same for everything, but here the amount of current changes. So this implies I is equals to V by R. That means the total amount of current flowing through the circuit is equals to total amount of potential difference across the two ends of the circuit divided by the total resistance of the circuit. Now what will be your I1? I1 will be equals to V by R1. What will be I2? V2 by R2. And what will be I3? That will be equals to V3 by R3. So now we substitute our equations in the following formula, that is I is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. That means the total amount of current which is getting input over here will be the amount of current output will remains the same, but here the amount of current distribution is different. That's why we are writing I is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Now what is your I? V by R, that is V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. So this implies V by R is equals to, take out V common, 1 by R1, 1 by R2 and 1 by R3. This V and this V gets cancelled. So 1 by R is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is your final derivation. So in this way, whenever the resistors are connected in parallel, it will be reciprocal of the sum of all the resistances, and if it is in series, it will be a normal sum of all the resistances. So here we saw the difference between series combination and parallel combination. So here, I hope now your concept is very clear with the resistors connected in series and parallel combination. Now in my next class, you will be watching how the heating effect of electric current affects the conductors or affect the resistances. So the next topic will be continued in our next videos. Till then, goodbye.
For more updates, subscribe our channel, click the show links and enjoy watching the videos.